let's say you hear about this new thing called showering, and you hear that, oh, you're going to get really clean if you shower, and you try it, and wow, you get clean, but then you stop showering, and you're not so clean anymore. And then you say, well, I tried this fad showering thing, but it's just a short-term effect. Doesn't work long-term. Probably you wouldn't, because in all these other cases, we expect there to be, you know, you just have to keep doing it, right? And I think the exact same thing is true for any lifestyle intervention, including any dietary change. To make it work long-term, you have to do it long-term. And that should not be so surprising. So let's look at this study where they actually kept losing weight for the full year. They measured their ketone levels and they found that they were elevated the whole period, meaning that most people seem to be following this diet. So what's different in this study? Well, it's not randomized, meaning people sign up for it because they want to do this diet, instead of signing up for a weight loss trial and then someone throws a diet, some dice and say, you know, you should eat a low-fat diet, or you should eat a vegan diet, or you should eat a low-carb diet. Maybe you don't want to do that. Maybe you don't like that. And why should you keep doing it for 2 years just because someone rolled the dice? You know, you wouldn't, right? So the compliance is much lower. I think this is actually a much truer representation of what happens if you start a diet that you believe in, that you think you can do, and that you want to do. And that means that the effect in all these RCT trials is an underestimation, most likely, of the true effect of someone who's motivated and want to do it.